Good morning, everybody. We are back. The show is called TBR, Double SF Show. It is myself, the Sobri Boys, Wadifatsi, joined by Swing Zack, Saddam Mack. Kosi, Kosi for life, how are you?
No, I'm all right, man. Money to Six is wearing kappa. That's nice. Kappa forever, fearless.
Kappa for life. Correle kapile lona bedi balona no. Kenna fela sa
no, you kappa, man. Yeah, happy Tuesday to everyone, eh?
Yeah. I want us to look at top eight. The draw is out, but prior to that, I want us to discuss Mamelodi Sundowns. We know that they've won, but the game was very, very tough. It was a slender win. I don't know, it's time to look at Mamelodi Sundowns. Mshege, as a coach, a former player, I'll want you to tell us a little bit more, but just greet the viewers first before we go there.
Greetings to everyone, the viewers out there, and greetings to Iswengu Lapo. I'm sure he was watching quality football this weekend, MTN 8. He was warming up for the start of the league. Yes, Prasobri, we watched Sundowns, and we also watched the other game, Cape Town City. Very interesting this season. Things are not going to be easy. It shows that it's covered guns. They don't want Sundowns to dominate. They dominated the season, so not winning. And I'm happy they got through that hurdle. It wasn't easy. It's not going to be easy with any team. Everybody wants to win, Brasobri, so it's not going to be easy. But they pulled through the end. And more to come.
We'll talk about that a little bit after a short while. So I want to analyze. I look at that game. I have my own views, but I want your opinion as a coach, as a former player. What did you see? Whether it's a first game or tactics were not good, you know, those kind of things. I want to look at that. Remember, you've just lost Lulane, and always there is adjustment that has to happen. And I can see that you are wearing kappa. Hola, hola, Mshege. Ujabule su Saddam, mawenza njalo. Saddam.
Number one.
Yeah, guys, but before, let's move here. We know that the champ has done very well. He won the silver with his team. This is the team that won the silver. And then four of them, it was a great thing, a great feeling. You know, to get silver in the Olympics is not a child's play. This is one race that is really, really tough. And then and then we are proud of what they did. And this is the final where, look at this. Yes, Akane here. He just got it a little bit there to remember it was a relay. And then, so I'm happy for them. And then, this is great. And then we are proud. We are looking forward to the champ when he comes back. Here is a silver, as you can see. He's kissing the silver. Who else? And then over and above, I must say, this guy from Botswana has made us proud, man. Teboho got a gold. You know, to get a gold in Olympics is not childish play. So, especially we as Africans, remember the Americans are advanced in terms of training technique, facilities, and all that. So, I'm very proud. So, Mshege, what do you want to say about the good job that has been done by our local boys?
Very well done, you know, from our African brothers. Simbini, you know, I really thought he deserved something, you know, after missing out in the 100 meters by split seconds, you know. a very close race. Anything could have happened. They could have got gold to bronze, but she got fourth position. So I was happy at the fact that come the relay, he was able to show us again his quality. When he received that baton, he was not second or third, so he had to cover ground and eventually win a gold, a silver for the team. So I'm very proud of him. And of course, Tebogo from Botswana did us proud, you know, in the 200 meters, which is normally dominated by the United States and Jamaica. But Tebogo showed his class and won that race with ease, you know, and the confidence that he had in him even after running that race. It's like he knew he was going to win it. So it's good to see Africans doing well in the sprints, really doing well. So we're happy for Tebogo from Botswana and of course our boy from South Africa, Simbine.
And well, this time I didn't see the Kenyans doing us proud. Remember, they normally do us proud, especially on the long distance. Even Jamaica, they struggle this time. Jamaica is one of those people, you know, when it comes to this, Jamaica, US, they're always neck on neck. But you know what? We are happy with what we have seen. So we wish them good luck. Mshege. Let's look at the results of top eight. You saw that Cape Town Spurs, they won against Kukune 1-0. And then, this is one thing that I like about committees. Committees is one leader, you know, every year he build his team. And then the next thing, he sell these players overseas. And they buy players from him, but I don't see committees losing it. So he's doing well, as far as I'm concerned. And then, because running a PSL team is not easy, it's tough. Eh? The money involved to run that team is not easy. So they've won 1-0, and then they're going to the next round, which is the semifinal. And then it's your game, Mshege, which I wanted to talk about, Mamelodi Sundowns. It was a slender win, 1-0 here. I don't know, what did you see? What was, was it the players were adjusting, one, or was it the effect of they were just coming back from preseason? All right. Some people are saying Mamelodi Sundowns normally struggle against Polokwane City. That's another thing. Was it the effect of Mangoba Mnguiti decided to overhaul the entire squad and brought new guys to play? Did that have an effect? And people were complaining why he did not start with Mshishi. Mshishi started on the bench. And then there were a whole lot of things. I don't know, what did you see there, Mshege?
Prasobri, I thought it was a good game of football. Obviously, you know, the supporters, they expect miracles. First game, they expect Sundowns against Polokwane to Sundowns to just dominate and win by a heavy margin. But football is not like that. Mm. And what I'm happy about mostly is that Sundowns did create the chances to score. So the score could have been 3-0 in the first half with Shaluline hitting the post, I think twice. You know, so they were creating the opportunity to be worried more if they were not creating the opportunities and then they win 1-0. But they created the opportunity, the score could have been if they had taken chances. So I have no problems, no quality time. Those chances will be taken by Shaluline. It's like that when it's in the middle of the way. The problem would be not creating the chances. If they were not creating the chances, I would have a problem. But they were creating the chances, they just didn't take them.
Okay. I think
also,
Your connectivity has a problem.
What do you expect every team that comes up?
Mshage, your connectivity has
okay,
a problem.
Okay, Prasanza.
It has a problem. I think if you can shift the position, Mshage is in Durban. If you can change the position, probably it would be much better. Saddam, while Mshage is still changing the position, because connectivity is giving me a problem here. Mshage says it's a new season, and then the boys have just come back from have just come back from the preseason. But the other thing that I looked at, I don't know technically or there was something wrong. I saw when Onyango was to be substituted. I don't know the new rules. Apparently, you cannot use all five during the first 90 minutes. You can use three in the first 90 minutes. The other two, you can use them during extra time. So they were nearly caught off guard there because they had to do Libusa as a goalkeeper. What's your take about that, Mshege? Was it did they work out their strategy very well, or Mangoba wanted to finish the game in the 90 minutes? Because that really nearly worked against them. Mshege?
Yeah, we nearly got caught off guard there when Onyango had to was out, you know. So yeah, I think Mangoba wanted to finish the game within the 90 minutes, but it wasn't to be, you know. Some games you really have to craft to win them. It's not easy, and eventually we won with the own goal. It's still a win, and I think we'll just pick up from here. As a team, you know, and get back to the Sundowns that we know. But it always takes time in the beginning of the season, you know, just to gel with the rest of the players. Like you said, the likes of Mshishi were on the bench, and Tashrik Matthews was given an opportunity in the starting lineup. So, yeah, you need to give the guys some time to gel, you know. But as long as the results and the winning mentality is still there, they will progress, they will do well.
Saddam, if I go to you, 58 fans, were you impressed with 58 fans? Kiabora, the supporters, the annual award, and got it over 59. I saw the other stand, I saw so many people in the yellow regalia, the yellow nation. What's your take? Were you impressed with the attendance?
No, first, I was not impressed with attendance. As you know, that MTN is a competition for any team to come, to any supporters to go support. Mm-hmm. We were there, I was there. I think you saw the supporters there, you saw the pictures. Mm-hmm. But in the field of play, it was not good as well. I'm still surprised because it's not the first time I see Zwane on the bench for the big game. On the cup game, he was on the bench, and then they lose. And then today they win, and then he was on the bench. How come you put Messi on the bench? Because I think Zwane is a Messi of Sundown. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to start with the game because the competition is very important. It's a killer punch. It's not about 90 minutes. That's why they went to extra time. When Sundown go to the field, they win the game before they kick the ball. That's why they undermine the Bulawayo City. How come they go to extra time? They nearly caught them. And then unlucky, Bulawayo City, they hit the ball, the goalkeeper as well. They nearly score the goals. But Sundown, if they can play like that, I don't see them going through to the final because Stellenbosch are very, very dangerous at this time. But anyway, the game was okay, but Sundown didn't play as Sundown that we know.
Mara, no, be fair, man. Sundowns, they were good attendance. They were not over at, but it was Sundowns. The attendance was good.
How many supporters were there? How many supporters?
I said 59. You know. I said 58 fans. When I go about,
can I tell you something? You know that Sundown supporters, they don't buy tickets. They go there for free. Can you do that to Pirates or Chiefs? They go for free.
Ulukile, but they were fans. They were fans.
Sundowns get tickets for free. They don't buy tickets.
Yeah.
I am
yeah.
No, man. I can show you a ticket. In a ticket, later say what in, yeah. What airtime? I got a ticket from somebody there.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Whatever, I don't go to stadium with a ticket. But I just saw people go to stadium. Around the stadium, only about to come around the stadium. They're drinking. They're sitting there. They're drinking. They don't go to stadium. Behind the stadium is a mall, but nobody go to stadium for free. Mahala.
Aye, man, I 58 fans. How did they go draw? There is a draw now coming up. Sundowns versus Stellenbosch, and then Pirates versus Cape Town City. Guys, I don't know whether you'll agree with me. I see Pirates gonna be hot this year. That's my view. And then you can agree or disagree with me. Pirates, it seems as if they're up to something. They are playing Cape Town City, and then Mshega, you are playing Stellenbosch. And remember last year, Stellenbosch really, really gave you a tough time. So how do you see this one?
Yeah, Prosopri, I would say these four teams that you see here in the semifinal are the best teams in the league.
Mm.
It's going to be a very tough one, tough semi-final. Stellenbosch are doing all the right things when it comes to their development as well. You can see they are doing all the right things. Their boys in the MDC are doing well. And Cape Town City, we spoke about committees earlier on. He definitely knows his football business, you know. That's why you see Cape Town City always on the top bracket, doing well in the league, you know. Even not with the biggest budget, but that's just the football grades within the committees, you know. You can see that they understand the football business. So, yeah, it's going to be a very interesting semi-final draw. Stellenbosch is not going to be easy. It's only going to get more difficult, you know. And they definitely want to get one over us, as we did that with them as well in the semifinal of last year's competition. So it's not going to be easy. It's going to be tough. It's going to be interesting. Also for Pirates and Cape Town City, it's not going to be easy at all. So it's a very interesting semifinal.
Now, Saddam, who's going to go to the finals? And give me a prediction here, Sundowns and Stellies. Saddam? Oh, Mshere? While
Hello.
Saddam, who's going to go to the final and give me the prediction of Mamelodi Sundowns versus Stellies?
Yeah, I think because they're going to play home and away, maybe the two teams can play, because when you lose for first game, you can still have a chance. It's a home and away, too late. But what I can see now, the favorite here, many people, they want to see Paris and Sundowns repeat of the final, but I don't think that will happen. Something is going to happen along the road, because those two teams, Cape Town City and Stellenbosch, they got nothing to lose. They can cause a damage and a problem and upset against the two teams. I see Stellenbosch go to the final.
Oh, Stellenbosch will go to the final.
Against Pirates. Yes.
Against Pirates. Now, while you're still there, who's going to win this tournament? We are going. Will Paris go again?
I think it's too early. It's too early to see, because let's go for the final, semi-final, and then we can talk about the final. It's too early to say who's going to win. Let's go to semi-final to say now. Pirates versus Stellenbosch at the final is where we can take from there.
Oh, come on, Zoma, I want the crystal ball. Naginali crystal ball.
Yes,
it will be Pirates and Sundowns. That's me.
Yeah.
It will be Pirates and Sundowns. But that would be nice to have that one. But you don't know. Cape Town City might have. Mshega, who do you think will go to the final? Do you agree with me?
I'm not surprised by Saddam's predictions. Now we can't say who's going to win the competition.
No, the thing is, you're excited. deep down, we are jealous. And food lady, I'm gonna be in so. How about that? Well, be the grand grand again. Hey, me, you listen.
A good.
How about that? Well, be the grand
grand. No. So, if you can see, Kentucky, we are not scared of Sundown. We just do our own mistake to make Sundown to win. We're not scared. We go pound to pound to Sundown. It's only this time when it's competition, Pirates can beat Sundown. But on the league, Sundown, the Pirates are scared of Sundown. But in normal game, this year I'm ready for any action.
Yeah,
ready
yeah.
for any action. I'm not scared of Sundown. I want them goals come. You know, I need a 6 point from Sundown or 4 point. I need a 6 point from Pirates or 4 point. Mm-hmm. They can't beat me twice.
All right, Ratabon. Kionye Barakimang Sopla here. Kibatuba how badu. Who's this one? Yes, Kisopla man, the guy on top, Kima.
Gijeri.
Oh, Gijeri. Can't say about him.
Yeah. Yeah, but this is a group that is going together when they go to stadium.
All right. Saddam, Kibono Hore, you guys have done the signings, and then I want to talk about that to check the signings that we have done. Here is Miguel, and then you guys have signed him, and then we see he has played for Petro Luanda, and then he has played for Mafra, Braga, Villarreal, and LK is LK what? And then those are the teams that he played for. And then he was born on the 12th of December in 1995. He's a tall guy. He's a central defender. So we'll watch the space. And the other thing that I've noticed about you guys as Kaizer Chiefs, your coach is attending games, which is quite good. He's attending games. And I saw this with, what is his name? With Hugo Broz. Hugo Broz attended the games, and then we saw what he unveiled. Now, here is Betway. He's coming very soon. Mshege, one of the first team that you play. Super Sport, you always play Super Sport right at the beginning of the season. And Royal AM will be playing Cape Town City. Amapakane will be playing Chipa, and Marumo Gallants will be playing Kaizer Chiefs. And then they call them Suwelele Samarumo, isn't it, Saddam? And Polokwane City will be playing Amazon. Bedway, very soon we'll be talking Bedway. And then, so those are some of the games that you're looking for. Saddam, thank you very much for showing up and then talking to us. And then, Ratabona, I think Sundowns will make the men's, they may win this tournament. If Pirates make a hat-trick of MTN 8, that would have been a good thing. But if you ask me, I think Pirates won't arrive this year. Mshege, do you agree with me?
But yeah, probably.
It's going to rise this year. They look like an oil in a an oil machine, you know.
Yeah, no, very impressive, such Pirates this season, Brasobri. But the MTN 8, we were tired of being dominated by Pirates. And that's why we've got Makoba Mkhithi, somebody who's got the pedigree that MTN 8, if you remember very well, he once hammered Ajax Cape Town 6-0 in the MTN 8 final. So I think he will play well for this one. And doesn't matter who we get in the final, but Sundowns will win this one.
I was impressed with Mamelodi Sundowns. They were in Australia. And then I saw Tlopi there speaking very well. What I like about him, he's a friend to the players. But I saw some characters of Dr. Patrice in him. But he has confessed that he's looking up to him. He's his Dr. Patrice is his mentor. But I was very much impressed. He's friendly to the players. They talk to him like a friend. 57 fans, Zeli 59, Kapanzeli 57 or 58, Saddam?
No, ba 58, ka Mamelo, all our Celtic. Mamelo, ba join in, ba 58.
Ba 58. All right.
In ba 57 plus one.
Plus one. Arta one.
Yeah, 58.
Okay, good luck, Saddam, for the season. Like I said, Kiboni something garele signe Aziz Ki. I don't know whether that's true. Mpulele, is it true or what?
No, it's still a rumor. Something fishy. Still a rumor. Wait for the chief management to make a proper arrangement and then an announcement. Because now it's a rumor. Everybody's talking about chips. I'm very surprised. It's a top eight. People are busy talking about chips. Chips are leading the pack. People, they don't want to accept.
Yeah. No, get la pehul.
Yeah.
Maro matateng this year. Matateng,
No, not this year.
I hope
this year I'm going to be a day. Not this year.
I hope you give the coach a chance. Thank you very much, Saddam. Much appreciated. Mshege, we are in eThekwini.
Ngiyabuya namhlanje, Prasobi.
Yeah, ngiyabuzwa mngani wami.
Yeah, thank you for wearing kapa, Chicks, well done for wearing kapa. Well done.
Yeah.
Lost my personal sponsor. Before they sponsor Chiefs, they sponsor me.
I was Saddam.
They were sponsoring Kaiser Chiefs 1989 until 1987. They were sponsoring Kaiser Chiefs.
Yeah.
You see me? This is my sponsor.
Yeah.
Here's my sponsor.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yeah. Much appreciated. Bye-bye.
Bells. Ooh. Oh. Whoa. Yeah. How you like my new coupe? Big body, put that thing on new shoes. Then I let the roof loose. Then make all my enemies call it juice. Whoa. How you like my new coupe? Big body, put that thing on new shoes. Whoa. Then I let the roof loose. My enemies call it truce. Whoa, record exec. I'm the guy out here that's cutting checks. Ooh. Check yourself. Another man's riches ain't your wealth. Whoa, and I'm doing well. I got all my double C's all up in Chanel. Big body trying to get the thing to parallel. Louis V, only time the boy take the L. Heavy on the scale. Dope boy. I'm such a dope boy. Whoa, can't dumb it down. I seen a standard change ever since I've been around. I heard them boys talking when I'm there, not a sound. I had to cut the throats, making sure I dig them down. Man, I dig them down, put them in the dirt. They try to put me down, but they put me in the murk. Cameras in the shit when the boy hit reverse. But I ain't going back. Dope boy. Ooh, I'm such a dope boy. Oh, dope boy. How you like my new coupe? Big body, put that thing on new shoes. Then I let the roof loose. Then make all my enemies call it juice. Whoa. How you like my new coupe? Big body, put that thing on new shoes. Whoa. Then I let the roof loose. Then make all my enemies call it juice. Whoa, man, we buy it out. At your own risk if you ever try it out. Hope you don't exceed. I got all my dogs, man, we on a different breed. If we ever want it, man, that thing becomes a need. Thinking on my feet, but I'm never on my knees. Shipping everything, I get my shit from overseas. Blue face, nose like a nigga moving keys. They don't know your name, man, you wanna leash your keys. Dope boy. Ooh, I'm such a dope boy. Whoa, dope boy. Ooh, I'm such a dope boy. Whoa, I gotta stay paid. Man, we never watching, but we know they up by face. Gotta feed a mom, man, there's so much on my plate. No matter what the phase, man, we never ever face. Never ever face. How you like my new coupe? Big body, put that thing on new shoes. Then I let the roof loose.
about to flip the script.